We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at The Raid, Issue 2 from Titan Comics. This is part of the miniseries based on the films, written by Ollie Masters, art by Budai Sentawan, colorist Brad Simpson, letterer Jim Campbell, editor Martin Eden. This is from 2018, of course, and we've got our main cast of Rama, who's undercover as Yuta, Beijo, who's like a ruthless gang lord, we got Hammer Girl and Baseball Batman, who are contract killers, and Tasia, who's a special operations cop. He's kind of new to the series, and he's undercover, and Tasia's in prison. Now, the issue is kind of cut between three people. Baseball Batman and Hammer Girl are doing their thing. Beijo is trying to do his thing, but there are obstacles in his way, and Rama and Tasia are in prison, and they got their own problems. So we intersperse the three storylines. We see Baseball Batman and Hammer Girl doing their thing. Beijo is more the focus of this issue. He's trying to set up a business, a restaurant. He's running into problems with a local enforcer, Hansamu, who is sort of running things in the area. He runs the street vendors and illegal meat. So that guy's trying to hone in on his restaurant and say, hey, you owe me protection money. And that's not going well. Meanwhile, Rama, who's in disguise as Yuta, is trying to help Tasia by saying that he's going to pay him protection money. So Rama's going to take the money as a cover for him actually giving him real protection, because he doesn't want to blow his cover. And there's a really great fight scene in the prison yard that looks really cool, and it's really well done. But the main story is, of course, Beijo and how he's dealing with this local mob guy. And it looks like issue 3 is going to make all three storylines converge. But it was a really good setup issue for what's coming next. If you haven't read issue 1, you'll probably get kind of the idea from the quick synopsis in the front and the dialogue between them, at least of what the characters are doing, but not how they're all related to each other. But I thought it was a really good issue. It definitely moves the story along quite well, and it does it in a very concise manner where you feel like it's very cinematic and the characters are slowly making their way toward each other to intersect in a really violent showdown. But it was good stuff. I thought this issue was really well done. I'm not familiar with the author's previous works, but from what I've seen so far, he's very talented and has a lot of potential. Seems to understand the medium of comics very well and is capable of doing good work. So as far as this issue goes, I'll definitely recommend it. If you can pick up both issues, 1 and 2, definitely do so. Issue 3 will be coming out in a few weeks, and I'm hoping to get that as soon as possible. But this is definitely good stuff, and I'm really enjoying it. It really does kind of have the feel of the movies. Not quite as violent, but the gore factor is definitely there, and it's hard to translate a lot of action scenes in one comic. But there's a lot of action here for a 32-page comic book, or 28, whatever it is, and I would definitely recommend this. So if you get a chance, if you like action movie stuff, you'll like this. If you like Asian crime lord movies, which who doesn't, you'll probably dig this too. Give it a chance. I think you'll enjoy it. But that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you want to support the channel further, Patreon links and Teespring links are in the description, and we hope to see you on the next one.